This isn't me. This is not me.
Do you mean to imply that it was I who went on an insane killing rampage?
I mean this can't be what I am, what I've become. It makes no sense.
What? You don't feel you are the logical product of your past? If that is the case, then I would like to know by what scale of logic you subscribe to that allows you to accept my severed head floating alongside you.
That's just it. The logic is fucked up here. There is something inherently wrong in this. You've been with me from the start, haven't you? Even before the nail hit the bunny, your voice was always in my head. Because it's my voice. Because you are me, the other end of my internal conversations. We all assign a voice to the aspects of ourselves, and I remember you always being there from the start. So you've seen what I've seen, felt it all, the people laughing and living their petty lives.
A world defined by its daytime talk shows.
You know what goes on in this world. They don't understand. They don't see that after their laughter subsides, in search of the next cheap thrill, their victims are still hearing the taunts in their heads. A cacophony of degrading noise, poisoning perception. These fucks acknowledge their own worthlessness by pursuing the mundane, inviting their own pain to confront them in the form of a furious victim. But I'm losing it, aren't I? I don't know which ones deserve my attention. And I lose things. Things leave me. I can't remember what it is to hold on to something. Friends leave. Everything leaves.
I suggest you seek some alternate source of sympathy, Nee. You tried to kill that girl. She liked you, and you tried to kill her. That was impolite. So you must prefer this to any pleasure they give, however brief it may be.
Well, no! Like I said, it makes no sense! I can't explain anything because I can't find it in me. I talk back, looking for what brought me here, but I only get images as if through a haze. I've done some pretty ghastly shit, and yet the clear motivation eludes me. These acts, they're more like answers to a question I don't even remember asking. Try to think back, but it only goes soft and nothing feels right or solid. I remember images, but like bad photographs printed on wet toilet paper, blurry and distorted, bits and fragments. I remember being little, other kids laughing at how skinny I was, calling me Noodle Boy. Typical shit, that's all. Why is it like this? I've done things, all those people, and acted like I enjoyed it! I'm doing this, and I can't even say why? I'm sure I'm not just in a bad mood!
Look around you. Can you remember being the person who made all of these paintings? You once threw everything of yourself into these things, feeding them with creatures in your head, paint and ink, where now there are barrels of blood. Am I the only part of you that remembers a time when your imagination was used to create things other than horridly paranoid delusions? And though the current situation could be just another one of those delusions, we'll say it's not. Whatever the case, it is evident your creativity is the victim of something. I mean, look at you! You devote more time to fuming over the stupidity of mankind than you do to what you once felt so much for. Your imagination has been subverted! And look at what's left! The extent of your work is that anemic piece of shit Happy Noodle Boy! A goddamn stick figure!
Dear Lord! You've been trying to warn me, haven't you? See? I told you it made no sense! All this senseless killing? What good is there in this when it is all too apparent that you don't kill your guests? You torture them, drill it into them, make them forget what comfort is, death frees them from the education I offer, let them understand first, then they can die! Stupid people, I would ask you to keep in mind that this should not be a source of moral guidance. That would be movies. But put away the knives and never allow yourself to forget. You are stupid. So why have I been collecting all the blood? I hate blood. Like I hate piss and sweat and shit and spit and all the other sewage of the organism. Just like I detest that fucking cream filling in a Twinkie. Now I ask you, my bunny, why would I do such things? As if I really had to ask. It's so entirely obvious. I'm being manipulated by some nameless demon scourge from beyond our plane of existence. It spoke to me in my own voice, letting me believe I was hearing my own conscience. I was losing sight of my own reasons, so I was weak. It just took over and I let it happen. Shit! It's not good. I've relinquished control of my insanity. We think we can live away from what we hate, but are defined by those very things. It feeds upon us, sustained by our belief that we're doing something right. We think we are so great in our protests, but we just become the bitter offspring of what we oppose. We become prisoners in our own cages. We begin to speak in badly constructed melodramatic prose! Oh, raging horror, make this stop!
For those of you who just tuned in, here's a recap. Something is happening.
As if things weren't bad enough before, now it seems I've become a servant of whatever the hell is behind that wall. I'd like to see somebody try to beat me in a hard luck story contest. We spend a forever building up our defenses, only to have that be what allows us to be controlled.
Excuse me, let me just interrupt your disjointed little musings here. Let me remind you that you've still no idea what you were like before all of this. Pity is one thing you shouldn't expect much of just yet.
Do you remember? Do you know how much of this is me and how much is what that thing did to me? What if it went away? The thing? What if it was like when a smoker quits? You think I'd get fat?
Well, I couldn't say. Although I would think that, with your bone structure, you would look revolting as an obese person. However, I do vaguely remember that you were somewhat different before. You still did ghoulish things, but for slightly different reasons.
Ah, a step in the right direction. Exactly how does one rid themselves of an infestation of this sort?
There's a question you should ask someone else.
Who? All the other things in here are still me, like you're me. You'll know just about as much as we do.
You've already said that you assigned your voice to various things. Like right now, you're basically having a conversation with yourself. But who would ever suspect that they were no longer the mind behind the other end of their internal conversation? The other voices have become self-aware.
The Doughboys! It's them, isn't it? They're not mine anymore, are they? That's who it's working through, and they're getting stronger. I saw them moving around on their own, and I get weaker, more confused. Fuck! 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 Shit, and other such explicitives! Fuck! I wish someone would just switch me off and fix me. Bunny?
Yes, Nate?
I'm not happy.
Suffering a world too vacuous to acknowledge his genius.
Wobbly-headed Bob.
Futility. The deluded collective suppresses my message. I've grown so weary of this crusade in vain. Ignorance prevails. What cruel fate to be moderately infused with only the desire to expand the minds of those fools who are buffered to any such improvement by their agonizing lack of the ability to recognize their own inanity. Well, no more! If there is one life I can affect, then that life be mine. God forgive my retreat, but my power has been wasted here in this land of depravity. So here, atop this peak, elevated in mind and in body, I jump to my conclusion. Time to die. May the rocks below be jagged and merciful in their deadliness. Onward to restful expiration! My blood will seep into the earth, and from it shall grow the fierce seeds of a new hope for...
I think you're pardoned, Mr. Bumblebee!
Oh no! No, please, dear God, no! Why me? Why me?
Hey, listen! Listen to me! You have to talk to me! Tell me why you're doing this! My friend! My friend needs help!
And I am helping him.
Why do you keep hurting him? Why only him? I mean, yeah, okay, he was being a real asshole, but don't you...
Somewhere in you must be enjoying this. Seeing your friend twitch at the feel of the venom his kind produce in the people they fuck with? Admit it, his admirable qualities are less than prevalent even in dealing with you, aren't they? How could you not entertain thoughts of his getting what he deserves?
Yeah, well, you know, but not like this! This is sick! Think about what you're doing!
Look, Daddy, the chicken is smiling.
I have! Unsettling, isn't it?
What is this place? Where are we?
Just another room in the world. That wall over there? Well, that's something else. Your friend should suffice for a fresh coat. I haven't painted it in over a week, you know. It started eating the dried blood now. I can feel it in there, smoldering. Furious at my disobedience. Furious at its disobedient little slave. Some people get magic genies, and I get this. Well, fuck you! You listen to me! If I'm gonna kill anybody, it's because I want to! Not because you tell me to! Yes, I'm the one that's been killing all those people. But I'm also the creative force behind Happy Noodle Boy. So forgive me and shut up!
Where's my snow cone?
All those people? Why? To paint a wall? That old woman? The ice cream man?
The cheerleading squad?
On the news, that girl. They found her dead and she was raped. That was you?
I would never! You stupid blind thing! I spent enough time trying not to be touched or be touched! The mere thought of such repugnance!
I would have nothing to do with the submission of physical longing that all seek to enslave you. And I've already got this ravenous beast of plaster to contend with. Flesh does not motivate me, no. Mine is a penetration beyond the veil of the flesh.
The fly?
What?
You're quoting the fly?
Yeah, why not? How lovely it would be to escape from these emotions. I seem incapable of ridding myself of their itch. They become an insect governed by necessity, not out of malice or other such distractions. See, I don't want to touch anything. I don't want to feel anyone, because I don't care about anyone like that. And to touch it is disgusting for all of its emptiness. It only reminds me of the emptiness. It would revolt me to hurt anybody like that. I can't help but feel the effects of it all. The distance, and it hurt. Why can't I just turn it off? If this is how it's gonna be, let me just turn it off! Like this bug! This bug that taunts me with its coldness! I keep killing it and it keeps coming back!
Help me! Help me!
You don't think maybe there's more than one bug in this place?
Don't be silly. Mr. Samsa, I'm afraid I must kill you again. Mocking me with your... Why did I come down here?
Tess? Tess, where are we? Mom?
Oh, yeah. I'll be back in an hour to do that again. Excuse me. Hello. You wouldn't happen to have a Band-Aid, would you? I could really use a Band-Aid. Oh, okay. Isn't this just funny? Normally I'm not at all concerned with stopping blood flow.
Did you hurt somebody? I heard something.
No, I don't think I could even stand to touch anyone lately. This is the first time I've been out all week. I'd still be in, but I cut my hand on a SpaghettiOs can. But, well, it's nothing serious. At least it gave me a different sort of reason to leave the house. Yeah. Man, look, I don't mean to bring you down. Feet! I'm sure you got your own problems. And hey, sorry I woke you. Don't worry about me doing the whole window thing anymore. I found a tunnel that leads from my house to your basement. It should be ready after I just clear it out a little. So you can sleep easy now.
Damn! I left the SpaghettiOs on the stove!
Well, good night. Don't let the flesh-eating demon bed babies bite!
Debbie, you really should get out. You've been in here forever. Come on, this week at the camera they're showing all the movies that never made any money because they force people to think. Tomorrow it's subtitle day.
No, he's out there. I'm telling you, he's been following me. Shit! This is so much worse than when that homeless torso man with one arm followed me around with that little red wagon.
So does this knee guy have all of his limbs?
Yeah. At least that wagon guy didn't have a free arm to hold any weapons.
You said you called the police. Didn't they do anything?
I called about 50 times. And when I called back, they never knew what the hell I was talking about.
Fuckers! They didn't do anything! They sounded like I had never called and reported anything at all. Aw, man, this is just too much. Do I know how to pick him or what?
And you were worried about bumping into the last guy you went out with.
Yeah, well, I don't have to worry about that anymore. Didn't you hear? Somebody threw explosives at him while he was on the toilet at that cafe. All they found was his legs with the pants around the ankles.
See? There's a good thing.
Yeah, but knee is a whole new thing. I think it's safe to assume that there's something wrong with him, but I don't understand. Tanya, if you'd only seen him, he was so nice, up until that knife attack thing. And now, I just know it. He's following me. I swear, I can feel him watching me. One time, I think I saw him. He was at the window at work. It was just a flash and then he was gone. Tanya, he looked like he was going to cry. That was the last time I saw him. It felt like such a good thing with him. Have you ever hated someone for making you like them? Like them so much, and then wish they would die?
But what makes you think he's still here? The cops must have at least gotten to his house. Probably got scared and left town. Here, call his number. I'll bet you there's nobody living in that house. Then maybe we can go to the movies tomorrow.
Hello?
I'll be staying in tomorrow.
You.
I love you too, honey. Bye-bye.
Mommy, where are you going?
You know where I'm going, dear. I'm going to work, like I always say.
Oh, okay. I love you, Mommy.
I know, sweetie. But don't be late for school. Love you.
Bye, Mom! I love you!
Oh, he is getting too old for this. Ugh. Goodbye, honey. I'll be home in a couple of hours. Go get ready and comb your hair.
I will, Mommy. Bye. Bye!
Come on. Goodbye, honey. Bye-bye. Bye!
Mom! I love you! Mommy! Mom!
I know you do, and Mommy loves you, so please calm down. Mommy loves you, and I'll see you soon. Okay? Okay, honey?
Okay! I'm okay, Mommy! But Mommy, I really love you!
Mommy! Don't leave me!
Okay, I won't leave! I won't! I'll stay here with you if you would just... Hey, look! Daddy's calling you!
Huh? Daddy? No, he's not, Mom. I don't see him. I don't...
Mom! Mom! Yeah! I love you!
Wait for him to grow out of this.
That's Billy standing on the street corner. But unlike other kids, Billy isn't waiting for the signal to change so he can go home. Billy doesn't have a home. Billy's a runaway. A stinking runaway.
There were problems at home, so I just left. I was 8. Never went back. My parents don't care. But I guess I'm doing okay, I guess. All the drugs usually help me forget where I am. I started small at first, just dope and glue. Then I started up with the crack and acid. A little heroin, when I could steal enough to afford it. It's harder to pay for all that now. Most of my money comes from handouts. The people feel sorry for me because I'm little. They think I'm a baby or something. But I'm actually 15 years old. All the stuff I put in me stunted my growth. And I put a lot of stuff in me. Yeah, when I really need something, I'll find something. Gasoline, paint, wine OP, junkie puke. I even shot up a Yoo-Hoo I found. I feel sick a lot. My pee is purple. Right now, I'm 2 days without sleep. And I'm high from shooting up with spoiled sour cream from Taco Bell. Sometimes I think of going home, I guess. I don't know. But I'm doing okay, you know. I'm used to this. Except for when that happens, I'm doing okay.
Kids, drugs won't help things. They'll only turn you into a hideous little freak troll baby with exploding eyeballs. You have hurt me, and, I guess I'm gonna kill you now. I guess, yeah?
No, please, I never...
Shit, I'm sorry. I just really can't do this. Not now. Fuck. Sitting here in this room is the last thing I want to do right now. I want someone to talk to, but there's only the din of raging static in my head. Only this noise of mine never leaves me. We're told to accept the fact that life goes on and that nothing is forever. Nothing! But I don't want to accept this. I don't want to see it all as just a dead thing before it dies. I had something! I had something beautiful! The world still spun around in all its arbitrary fury, and I had something to hold tight to. Something beautiful! And I fucked it up! I did exactly what I never wanted to do! I turned it into something cold and weary! Now, screaming in fear, I hold tighter, and it squirms away, pushing me off! And the faster I run to catch it, to hold it, the faster it runs to escape! The more it recoils from my touch. Dreaming of a world that has stopped dreaming of me. Going away, driven by the more desirable idea of new dreams, and I don't seem to be accepting it. And I don't want to accept! I don't want to get used to losing the few things that made me feel! I saw the filth, but I had something! And the noise in my head, with all its voices, repeats one thing, incessantly, more than anything else. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Don't let go of me now. Dream of me. Don't let me wake up. but I know that it is only noise. Shit, something beautiful. See? I killed you.
Oh dear. Look, F. He's going to kill himself. Oh, the raging horror of it all.
Yep. Shit on you! Holes in all of you! You ozone-unfriendly fucks! I'm tired. I know about what you two are doing. Sort of. I'm leaving, but I'm not doing this to satisfy you, psycho doughboy. Nor am I doing it despite you, Mr. F. I do it simply to rest.
You notice, perhaps, that I am not smiling. See, you never really mean to kill yourself, you pathetic tick. Oops, I'm being unfriendly, aren't I? Well, I've grown so sick of seeing you make a mockery of self-annihilation.
Yes, well, this should do the trick. I want out of this. Nail Bunny stopped talking yesterday. I know you know why. You've stolen too much of me. I'm through with being used.
That's right, me, you little shit! Free will and all that rot! Come on, you're a slave! Just play the game a little longer. Soon enough, you won't even be needed. What exactly do you have set up here for today's show?
Simple, Mr. Fuck. I've set the arm up with a motion tracker. It's also connected to the telephone. Lifting the phone activates the tracker. It'll follow me, but won't fire the gun until I speak into the phone or try to turn off the arm.
Neat! Oh, please, spare me this. Here is yet another of his false attempts. The little shit lies. Tell me, Johnny C, who is going to call you? Nobody ever calls you. Not even wrong numbers, and you know it! When was the last time that phone even rang? Especially at 2 a.m. Nobody wants you. You've chased them all away. Pusillanimous wretch. Peering over the edge of the abyss, but never strong enough to jump.
You want so much for me to die. Why haven't you just killed me yourself?
I can't. But trust me, I would love to. To serve my master. I am, however, not strong enough.
Not yet, anyhow. But get this, Knee. He doesn't even care about being strong enough. He actually does want to serve his master.
Me? Well, I need you alive a little longer, so just ride it out.
You know what? I don't even know how I came to live in this house. I guess pretty soon, I won't even remember Nail Bunny.
It's all so very distressing, is it not? So what is the point of remaining? Be serious on this journey. I apologize for what I said earlier. I'm your friend. Kill yourself. Do it for your friend.
No! I control me! I control me! Hurrah! Yippee! Fook, fook, nicely done, dear boy! Now quick, go kill something! The barrier grows thin! Don't let it escape! Let's go mutilate Cupkins! Fuck you, F! I'm not feeding the wall, and I'm not killing myself after all! I'm turning the arm off, and I'm taking charge of...
Hey, you didn't fire the gun. I am so lucky. I...
It wasn't on to begin with, you idiot!
Who the hell? Somebody's calling me? Somebody's calling me!
I beat you guys. Things will be different now. I feel it.
Hello?
Happy Noodle Boy!
Even our courageous hero falls victim to times of sadness. And if you look closely enough, you will find pimples on anybody's face. Noodle Boy contains no soy!
Excuse me. Maybe you can help me.
I don't think so. What's wrong with him?
Scooby Flooby Booby!
I don't know. I woke up and he was on my head.
What? Cease your barky noise making! Join my Legion of Darkness, my frowny face empire! Squealy bladder fuck! Now my plan comes to fruition! Minutes of planning! Finally, my toes wiggle! I anoint thee! I do not copulate with Twinkies! Ah! Sloop! Soon now, my pretty! Can you not feel my masterpiece unfurling before your very spleenies? Filled with chewy nougat! Victory! Success! Incontinence! Now with more leakage protection! Supplicant! Acknowledge me as the nipless wonder! Go forth and be a happy cabbage! Your service is complete! Get me some fucking corn nuts! Accept my heartwarming gift of tree scratchies!
I absolve thee!
Hokey pokey havoc moi! Hokey pokey, you shitting penile feather! Get down!
Okay, Mr. Noodley, leave the people alone! I am the policeman who punches heads! Now move along, you insane freak!
Moo! 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 I'm voodoo cursing you!
Hey, kids! Here's a fun project for you to do! Collect all your Happy Noodle Boy comics and crumble them up into little balls! Don't they look neat? Start building a pile of them in the middle of your room! Now, enjoy!
Dear Diary, I seem to be dead.
If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon. Patreon.com/selfpityentertainment.